Hello, welcome back. This is the Love and Spiritual Hands. Today we're going to do another update on Ochosi. I did promise I was going to come back and do that, and I'm doing it today. Today is Wednesday. This is a day that I usually work with Ochosi. I work with them every day, but this is a day that I really designed to work with them that was given to me. This is not an altar. This is just an idea so you can get the concept of what it is that we're doing. We have his statue, beads, water, the same basic equipment that I had in the first video, cigar, candles, prayer card, coconut, Cascadilla blue, Florida water. We have the Ochosi oil, which is on the website. We have the Just oil, which is on the website. We have Success, which is on the website. And of course, I have some Cascadilla for my personal use. I have coffee, different things out, so that way you can get an idea or have some type of plan in mind. When you look at what I have, you do what yours, the way you want to do it. I'm not telling you how to do anything. I'm just giving you a little example of different things you can do. I did not find any red apples, so I had to use green. Of course, you have to use what you got. I'm sitting in my kitchen. I use what I have. I'm just bringing you the knowledge. It's up to you whether or not you want to receive it. Usually when I work with them, I usually use Cascadilla on my hands because I do a lot of different stuff, so I don't want to bring any type of negativity to the Orishas, the ancestors, when I'm dealing with them at all, period, because that's who have to protect, guide, lead, and also walk with me. His beads is around his neck here, his bowl, different things comes with this statue. Hopefully you can see it properly. I usually rub him down in palm oil and different herbs. We had did that in the first video. Today we're going to come and talk about spiritual thieves when you're dealing with Ochosi. How not to be a spiritual thief when you're dealing with Ochosi. You have to be very careful when you're dealing with Ochosi. Ochosi is a man of justice. He's a hunter. He never misses the mark. We talked about that before. I'm just reiterating that again today. Ochosi lost his mom because he had went hunting, and she had took a bird that he had found and actually hunted, and when he got home, she was trying to prepare it, but when he got home, it was missing because she had it. So he thought someone else took it from him, and he wanted justice. At that point, he wasn't thinking clearly, and he didn't really understand what was going to come with it. When he went for justice, they asked him, "Are you sure you want justice?" And he said, "Yes." And that's how come he got into the Orishas and the ancestors, because he really wanted justice. The person who granted him justice, we're going to get into that in a separate video because it's a separate ancestor he went to, said, "Okay, we're going to give you the justice." As he gave him the justice, he heard the cry. He knew that the cry that he was hearing and the noise that was being made was a cry from his mom. And then he said, "Okay," you know, he actually lost his mom because he wanted justice. She was trying to prepare this meat for him, but yet he had hunted it. And so you have to be careful. He hunted and thought somebody took it from him, and he lost something. And in all reality, he wanted justice, and he ended up losing his mom over it. But in regards to that, he ended up being one of the greatest Orisha to bring justice, working with the ancestors. Ochosi's also symbolized as a tracker, symbolized as an eagle. Hawks, you have to be careful when you're dealing with them. They see things different than humans see it. They have a more precise vision. You have to be careful. You cannot go out here and do something wrong to somebody and they go to Ochosi and they ask for forgiveness, or they ask for I didn't do anything wrong. This person just don't understand what's going on. Now the other person that you did wrong to can go to Ochosi also. This is his candle. I'm sorry if I didn't mention it in the beginning, or I didn't show it to you before. This is his candle. They can go to Ochosi now and seek justice. That's why I always say when I use the Ochosi, I use the oil, and I use Just Judge and Success and many different things depending on what client I'm working with or what situation I'm working with. You have to be in the right when you are working with Ochosi. You cannot be a thief. You cannot steal someone's idea. You cannot steal someone's home, relationship, or any other things like that that do not belong to you, using spiritual manipulation to come out a winner in the spirit, in the flesh. This person can go back now in spirit and say, "Listen, hey, I want justice for what was done." Ochosi does not miss the mark. Lo and behold, you may want justice, and guess what? Somebody that's close to you might be getting the heat because they're the one that has done you wrong. Be careful. you take any type of knowledge from somebody that you have stolen, give them credit for it. Give them credit. Say, listen, hey, I took this idea from somebody. I'm just going to and add it on to it. Shout out to this person. This is it. You cannot wait for someone to make a name for themselves, make a family for themselves, or anything else like that, a business for themselves, or a dream for themselves. And here you come and you steal that from them and you think it's okay. It's not okay. You cannot go and lie against somebody and think it's okay. Oh, well, I could do that and get away with it. They don't know nobody. They think it's not me doing it. The ancestors know. He is a tracker. He will track you down. You have to be careful when you are dealing with spiritual things. You have to be careful. You can go to somebody and get work. Oh, I know that my neighbor or a colleague at the job is going to be successful. I want them to lose everything they have. This person may get help from somebody, and the person they're using is Ochosi. You have to pay for that. You have to pay for that. You cannot use spiritual things to take away someone's stuff and think it's okay. I'm not knocking anybody. I am not discrediting anybody. Be aware, be careful, be alert, be protected, and most important of all, be consciously mindful of what you're doing. You cannot steal something from the ancestors. They may be working with this person for a long time to get that gift. It may not even be anything of tangible needs. It just could be a gift, maybe good sleep, maybe their peace of mind, and you're here stealing their peace of mind from them, and you think it's okay. It's not okay. When you're dealing with Ochosi, you cannot have mental health issues. You have to be precise. This is someone that does not miss the mark. You have to know what it is you're going after, why you're going after it, and who is going to be hurt if you're in the wrong. You have to be careful. That's why I always tell people, make sure you know what you're doing. If you don't know what you're doing, say, listen, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm going to back out now. I didn't understand. Please forgive me. Whatever. People say you're not supposed to apologize. Yes, you are. When you are in the wrong, you are in the wrong. Ochosi works very well with Ilegwa and Ogun. You could put them together in that environment if they are willing to work with you in that environment. They may want to be spaced out, but it's up to you how you're willing to work with it. Usually when I deal with him, I usually put an evil eye around his candle to block out certain negativity. Because see, people like to do things to you and go ahead and use their powers to stagnate people in life. That's another person you can go to. When people are doing things to hinder your goals, your dreams, your vision, people are wicked. You have to be careful. When you are seeking justice, you're going through courts, you know you owe back child support, you never gave the person a dollar extra, 10, 15 years, you're paying the same amount. You know you're in the wrong. You cannot go to Ochosi and do that. You know you're in the wrong. You know you are. Do the right thing. Clean up yourself. You have to be careful when you're going to certain people to get work done. You're saying, oh, you know, this person is doing good and bad at the same time. Everything is all right. Everything is okay. Yeah, they're not going to tell you that this person is going to get help. They're not going to tell you that this person is fully aware and is spiritually inclined and they know what it is about. You have to be careful. With that, I'm not going to take up no more of your time. We have the Ochosi candles on my website. Always give them coffee. As I've always said before, their water. He has Florida water, his coconut. This is not an altar. I'm just bringing it forward to give you an idea. Do not be afraid to introduce yourself to any Orisha, any ancestor, or any type of spiritual guides. Do not be afraid at all. Start off wherever you feel comfortable and work your way up. Work your way up with them. Take your time. Be thankful. Be grateful. Most important, be disciplined. You have to be a disciplined child. You cannot say, oh, they said no and I still want it. No, that's not them. That's your mind playing with you. That's what we talked about, mental illness. Be alert. Be aware of who you're challenging. I don't challenge people. I don't care how much people try to say that. Oh, I'm stronger than you. My words mean power. No, no, no. If your words had power, then you will realize that you are not bigger than the universe or the ancestors, the Orisha, any type of spiritual guides that you have. Respect yourself. Respect spirituality. Respect the ancestors. Respect Ochosi. Sending you lots of love. Firm meditation. Sending you guidance. Sending you justice. Sending you things that people stole from you as a child, right back at you. nothing but love and light. Sending you things that people try to hinder from you. Years of torment. Sending you nothing but a clean bill of health. Clean bill of freedom. When you're dealing with Ochosi, ask him, Daddy, how can I get out of it? Show me. Show me how to go out there all in the field. That's where he has to work with Ogun and Ilebwa. Baba, how can I get to it? He will show you how to hunt your goals, your vision, prosperity. It may not come in all at once. You may make a dollar one day, $40 the next day, $99 the next day. Be grateful. Take it. Take it. You get an idea, you know, somebody else's idea. Give them recognition. You don't have to call their full name. I got this idea from somebody, and I'm just adding in my 2 cents, and I'm just, don't just take the person's stuff and say, okay, well, I came up with it. No, you didn't. You are a thief. Don't misuse the elders. Don't misuse any type of Orisha. Take your time. Learn. Take your time and learn. Before I leave, subscribe. Leave a like, leave a comment. I will get back to you because all this week I'm going to be answering comments. All this week, I'm uploading back to back to back to back. Take your time once again, people. Children of Zion, take your time. Ashe, so mote it be. I'm out.